this video, we're going to use calculus to figure out one of the most important problems in statistics, namely finding the best line through a bunch of data. So, to be specific, we're going to find the best line through these 3 points, 1, 0, 2, 1, and 3, 6. And I put best and through in quotes because, of course, there is no line through those 3 points. They don't lie in a straight line. And so, when I say through, I mean roughly through. And any line that you draw is going to be off. It's going to miss one, two, or three of the points by different amounts. And we want to come up with some sort of measurement of how good a line is and then pick the best one. So to parameterize our lines, every line can be written as y equals mx plus b. So m and b are the coordinates that determine what line we're talking about. And then for every value of m and b, we can figure out how far off is the line. And then we want to minimize the amount that it's off by. And the line that minimizes the amount that it's off by is going to be our best line. So let's be a little more precise. And we're going to set up the machinery not just for 3 points, but if you had a whole bunch of points. So we've got a bunch of points. The first point is x1, y1. Next point is x2, y2, x3, y3, x4, y5, all the way up to xn, yn. And through that, we're going to claim that we're going to take our line, and we say the line is mx plus b. And we want to see how far things off are. Now, for each value of x, you can say, what is the line is predicting that the value should be this much, but it's really this much. And then over here is predicting it should be this red point, but it's really up here. So we will call the predicted values pi. And the formula for pi is you just plug in xi into the line. Mxi plus b is the predicted value. So this is the point x1 comma p1. And this is the point x2 comma p2. And this is the point x3 comma p3. The points on the line have y values of p1, p2, p3, and their x values are the same as the original x values. And then the error is the amount that it misses by. So this distance here, that's going to be our first error. Let's call it e1. And our second error is going to be the amount that the second point misses by. And the third error is the amount that the third point misses by. So in general, the error, call it EI, is the predicted value minus the actual value. And what we care about is we're going to add up the squares of all the errors, add them up for all n points, and this is our function E, which depends on M and B. Why do we use squared error? Well, a couple reasons. One is when you take squares, you have the positive errors and the negative errors. You see here the point was too high, here was too low. When you square things, they don't cancel each other out. The other reason is that when dealing with squares, the math comes out really nicely, as we'll see. So, okay, the function we're looking for is the sum, and whenever I write a sum, I'm talking about all of the n data points. I'm going to write it in once I goes from 1 to n, but for the rest, I'm not going to bother writing in the I equals 1 to n. So this is the quantity that we're adding up, and taking a derivative of that with respect to m and b. M and b are the variables. X, I, and y are a bunch of numbers. So the derivative with respect to m and b, well, that's, you just use the chain rule. Derivative of something squared is twice that something times the derivative of what's inside. And so if you expand that out, it's 2m times the sum of xi squared plus 2b times the sum of xi's minus the sum of the xi yi's. Okay, that's the derivative with respect to m. And we can, you know, turn that into an equation for m and b. You see, divide by 2 and you say m times the sum of the squares plus b times the sum of the x values equals the sum of the x times y values. And we can do the same thing for derivatives with respect to b. The derivative with respect to b is just 2m times the sum of the x's plus 2b times n. You get 2b plus 2b plus 2b n times, minus twice the sum of the y's. And you can get an equation for m and b like that. And you put the equations together, and you get two equations and two unknowns. Now, what I've done here is I've introduced a new notation here. The angle brackets means average. So when I write the average value of x squared, that's the same thing taking the sum of all the x squareds and then dividing by n, because we're averaging instead of summing. The average value of x is the sum of all the x's divided by n. The average value of xy is the sum of all the xy's divided by n. So all I've done is I've taken this equation and this equation and divided it by n, and dividing this by n becomes the average value of x squared. This divided this by n, you get the average value of x, and so on. So equations become, well, there they are. And that's just two equations and two unknowns, and we can solve that. If you take the second equation and multiply it by the average value of x, you get this. And if you subtract that from the very first equation, you cancel out the b's, and then you just solve for m. And there you go. We've got our formula for m. And if you look back here, b is going to be the average value of y minus m times the average value of x. And you do a little bit of algebra, and you discover that there's the formula for b. So the formula for m, average value of xy minus average value of x times average value of y divided by average value of x squared minus average value of x squared. And b has the same denominator, except it's x squared, y, x, and xy. Okay, now let's go back and do our original problem. In our original problem, we wanted to figure out the 3 points. We had the 3 points 1, 0, 2, 1, and 3, 6. Well, if x is 1 and y is 0, then x squared is 1, and xy is 0. If you have 2 and 1, then x squared is 4, and xy is 2. If you have 3 and 6, then x squared is 9, and xy is 18. And then if you add them up, 1 plus 2 plus 3 makes 6. This makes 7. This makes 14. This makes 20. And if you want your averages, well, 6 divided by 3 is 2. 7 thirds, 14 thirds, 20 thirds. And then we just plug in our numbers. And I'll spare you the arithmetic. When you plug this in, you get 3. When you plug this in, you get negative 11 thirds. And our best line is y equals 3x minus 11 thirds.